Hey everyone, I'm Sam from BioCosplay. In this video series, I'm going to show you how to make a muscle suit. In this first video, I'll be showing you how to make the patterns for one.
I have pretty long arms, so I get the body suits with hands in them, and then I just cut the hands off. Make a line with a little chalk wheel right under the thumb. Just cut it off. And then also, the ones with the hands usually come with closed feet. So same thing with that, just clip the toe off. So then I end up having too much down at the foot and then not enough on the arms. So I'm gonna cut some off the foot and put it on the arms. Right, Porchy? Thank you, Porchy.
Okay, we got the bits that were cut off the feet sewed onto the arms. I'm going to be putting this bodysuit on a duct tape mannequin, like this one. There are a decent amount of tutorials online for how to make one of these, but I can make one if you really want me to. Before that though, I want to trace some of the muscles onto the suit while I'm wearing it, so I have a point of reference for where everything is on me. Because things like the elbows and the knees, it's hard to pinpoint exactly where it is on the duct tape mannequin because it kind of smooths everything out.
I got my spandex suit put on the duct tape dummy. Now I'm going to cover it in masking tape. You can kind of see some of these blue lines here where I marked it with some chalk while I was wearing it to try to map out where some of the muscles are. That was mostly because the way the suit fits on the duct tape dummy isn't exactly how it's going to fit on me. Like the limbs are a little bit more tubular. Doesn't really have the elbow and knee creases. You can see here the knees mapped out, but that's not really where the knee is on this dummy. I think it's like up here. So just the way it stretches and stuff is not always exactly the same. And also like here I marked the elbow crease, so I know where my elbow bends. Since all the muscles on this should be symmetrical, I don't have to put tape on the whole thing. I could just do one side and pattern it that way. I'm gonna start by putting tape just down the center. And then I'm gonna put tape horizontally and just try to keep it as flat as I can. You could also just lay pieces of paper on here and draw them on that way if you prefer. I just like the tape because then it doesn't move around. Sometimes with a flat piece of paper, when you're trying to conform it and get everything lined up, it's shifting around, and I find it to be kind of annoying when I'm trying to figure out where everything goes. Alright, I've got my spandex bodysuit put on the duct tape dummy, and now it's been covered in masking tape so I can draw on my patterns. Next step is to draw a center line. For that, I'm going to use this fabric measuring tape. I'm just going to line it up with the center of the crotch seam and roughly where I think the center of the neck is. While I do this, I'm also going to outline the seam on the neck for the collar. This doesn't have to be exact, it's just going to give me a rough guideline for where the muscles are going to go. Off camera, I also marked out where my belly button is. That would be useful for when we put in the ab muscles. Now we can start drawing on the muscles. For this, you can just pull up some muscle anatomy reference. If I know the name of the muscle I'm trying to draw, I'll just Google that, so like a pec muscle. I'm not an anatomy expert, so I don't know the names of every single muscle, but if you just look up general muscle anatomy, you'll get some reference for what we're trying to do here. Also gonna look at some action figures. I have a lot of action figures, so for this suit, I'm wanting to use it for Nightcrawler. I have a Nightcrawler figure here. This anatomy isn't 100% accurate, but if this is the look I'm going for, then I can use this as reference. It doesn't particularly have to be 100% accurate if there's a specific look I want. Also, I like to use this Broly figure from Dragon Ball Super just because the muscles on this are super pronounced and you can kind of pick out where everything is. Of course, it's broken up by the articulation, so like the shoulders aren't going to be super useful because they need to hinge. Otherwise, kind of gives me an idea where things go. So then for drawing out the chest, I held the mannequin up to myself and my wife put a dot under my chest right there just so I have some rough reference for where I should be ending the muscle. I like to start by outlining where the chest meets the shoulder, so I know I shouldn't really go past this area here. With actual muscles, there's a strip that comes over this way and attaches it. If we're going to be doing this in foam, though, that's just going to bend and wrinkle and get in the way of mobility, so you don't necessarily have to do that. Then I'm going to come up here and just follow roughly where my collarbone would be. Follow this all the way up, it's going to make a point. You could do that
I think the points on foam muscles tend to wrinkle and cause, again, just wrinkles and creases in the muscle suit and don't look great, so I try to round things over. We can round this over up here. And I'll probably tweak this later. I'm just trying to get the rough forms in right now. This is a hard angle, so this would be rounded in, and then we'll come here. This would also be an angle pointing downward, so you have an angle going in this way and an angle going in this way. And we'll round that over roughly to there, and then we'll try to meet up with this line coming out this way. So there's roughly where a muscle shape should go. Again, I'm probably gonna tweak the shape of this, but I have it roughly where I think I want it. I might make it a little bit pointier over here. Kind of give it more weight on this side. I'm also probably not gonna leave it pointing out this way. I'm gonna round it in. Just so it's not bumping into my armpit and again hindering mobility. Even once this is transferred to foam, I might still change the shape a little bit, because until it's stuck down, you can change it as much as you want. Then underneath that, we're gonna do a curve going down this way, following the rib cage sort of. And then from here we can start putting in the stomach muscles. This is where having the belly button marked out is going to be useful, because that's where we know where the abs will end, basically. For this suit, I think I want this section right under the chest to go underneath the chest, so the chest will sit on top of it and kick the bottom out a little bit. I might even only attach the top here, so that way when I bend over, it can move over top of that muscle right under it. So I may end up doing, you know, if the muscles maybe have it like up in here and come out on the side of the chest, come down to the side here, and then we'll deal with what's on the back later when we flip it over. So I'm just gonna put a straight line here for now. So then to determine where I want that to end, we have to break this up into three sections, because you have your three abdominal muscles here, then your belly button, and then one big one going down to the crotch. Some people, if they have the extra connective tissue, they'll have one more breaking up between the belly button and the crotch. Not everyone has that, so you don't necessarily have to put that there if you don't want to, but you can if you want to as well. A lot of superhero comics will have this muscle right under the chest, super big, like one solid piece, and then the abs, and they'll do the extra one down there as well. We'll say roughly there, and there. And then, I like to do a line roughly like 3/4 of the way over on the chest, from there, and do like a slight inward slope down towards the crotch of the suit, and use that as my guideline of where these are gonna end. So we'll do the middle one first, because if I do the middle one first, it'll give us the top of the bottom of the top one. We're gonna give it a slight hump on the top, and then back down, same on the bottom here, and then same thing out from the belly button. And then with this one, if I want, I can just bring this all the way down over here to the side from there. Depending on what you want, you can have this be one solid piece, or if you want to have extra definition there, you can have the seam in the middle and round it over and have that extra definition. It just depends on what you want with the suit. And then down here, this sort of just rounds up, and I'll just end this wherever it's comfortable on the suit. And that'll come with the fitting. This might be a little bit too wide as well, but we'll tweak it as we go. Then on the hip, right here under this side, we're gonna do like a crescent moon shape. Sort of like this. And you could either make this a crescent moon up here as well, or when you put this in, you can just taper it under there and have it just hug the side of the abs here. So again, that kind of depends on what you want to do. That's the chest roughly mapped out. I think we're going to taper this in a little bit more. I was doing it from the side, and I didn't want to get in the camera, but I think it's more like this. maybe somewhere in there, that might be a little bit better.
Also, if you make any lines that you want to erase on the masking tape, you can just take a piece of masking tape and cover it up, and then just redraw over it. We'll also want to round out all of these shapes at some point, because you don't have super hard edges all over your body. You don't have a ton of pointy bits inside of you. So all these, once I tweak the shape to where I like it, that's going to have a round edge. Round edge. I might leave it on the pattern until I get it on the foam. That way I have a little bit extra to work with in shape.
For the bicep, basically just going to do an oval here.
Then I like to do the shoulder and the bicep roughly at the same time. For the shoulder, it's kind of just like a big teardrop shape.
Just, you want room so it's not going to bump into the chest muscle, but you can tweak that once it's on foam. And it's going to wrap back around on the back here as well. And then up on the top, there's going to be room for this neck muscle and back muscle that comes up here. So I usually put a line like roughly halfway between the neck and then work with the shoulder from there. Sometimes I'll curve the shoulder in this way. And then if you want more striation in the shoulder, you can make this three pieces. So you just do an oval in the middle. These two crescent shapes on the side, and that would give you your shoulder striation. On the side of the arm, there's a little muscle here, and then on the back you have the tricep in here. This will round over at the bottom and make like two separate little sections
like that.
Kind of like that sort of shape. And then out from this point, you can do the elbow. Your elbow will be in here, and you'll have a point coming from the top and then from the bottom. And then you can make an elbow shape protruding from there if you want to have a pronounced elbow. Or if it's a pretty slim suit, you can use your own elbow and just leave that out. Going back to this muscle on the side here, between the bicep and the tricep, you can kind of save that for later and just fill in the gap between these two depending on how big you make these, but it's just going to be like a tapered strip in there that flares at the top and at the bottom. And for the forearm, I just continue a line down straight from the center of the elbow, and on the front as well, just a line straight down the front here basically. And we'll kind of trace out the top of the forearm there, and then another round section on the inside up here. And then when we cut out the muscles, these will have more mass up here and kind of taper in. And I usually overlap these just slightly in the front and the back. For the thighs, there's going to be three muscles in here. They're all going to be sort of teardrop shape. One on the inside here, one big one in the middle here, coming up this way, and then one over here. Actually, like this big at the bottom, and then tapers up at the top like that. Those aren't the exact shapes, but roughly like that. So my knees down here, we'll bring this one down a bit. Curve it up into where this one's gonna be. Back out this way. I kind of make them hit like halfway on the sides of the legs. And then on the shins, not really anything on the inside of the shin. If you look at your shin bone there, it's kind of just flat up against the bone. There's some on the back, but I'll flip it over and show that. On this side though, there is also coming around that way. All right, so here's the back of the calf, come up here. You could split this up into two muscles here, just two big ovals. Or you can have that be one oval, depends on your preference and how much definition you're going for. And then sometimes I like to put a little tendon going down the back here, flares out at the top, and it tapers down into the ankle. And coming off of this outer oval, the outside of the leg, I'm just gonna round that from the top down into this center line on the shin. So then that, all down the side here, will be one muscle. And then the inside of the leg will just have this one here that kind of cups the side a little bit. And have it kind of peek around the front just a smidge. That way when you're looking at the front of the leg, you can tell there's some muscle poking out from the back. I mean, depending on how much you want, you can bring this down this way. I usually just do just the one small one up here and have it peek over a little bit. On the back, we've already got a center line because of the zipper. I'm just going to continue that down to the butt. So then the back muscles, there's a big shape here that tapers down from the shoulder. Let's say it's roughly to where this zipper is already. It's like this big shape going this way. And then we've got one coming around the side, like this. You can kind of meet that up with the side muscle you've already made at the front. And that kind of tapers down to where the butt is, kind of like a V shape this way. So up here, coming up to the neck, this kind of depends if you're gonna leave the collar on your bodysuit or if you have one with a collar. Some things you might want to come down a little further so it doesn't peek out at the top. That kind of determines if you're gonna do the neck muscles or not. If you are gonna do the neck muscles, we can kind of have fun with this shape in here a little bit. You can make sort of like a diamond coming out from where the spine would be to kind of accentuate this neck muscle and the back muscle here. And this would just be flat, or if you want to put spine shapes in there, you can. Then this we're going to tweak a little bit coming up the top of the shoulder. And then this isn't exactly what it's like, but there's multiple layers of muscles going on here, so we kind of have to pick and choose what we want to show in the muscle suit. So I like to put like a little sort of triangular bit in here. That kind of bridges the gap between this big back muscle and the armpit and the shoulder muscle. So it's just a little lump there. So the way this bottom one coming up from the butt works is it kind of just makes like a straight line up into the armpit. But you want to continue the rib cage back here. You can do that as well. Kind of where the different layers come into play and you have to kind of pick and choose what you're wanting to show. You can bring the rib cage back. We could just cut it off there and just taper it in. And you know, we got the hip muscle coming around. We can just try to blend that into the butt. And then have these ab muscles come back and just stop there as well. I think I'm going to tweak the size of these a little bit. I think instead of having this so low, I'm actually going to put it in here. Have this overlap this one here. And then we can, you know, bring this, shift this down a little bit, make this a little bit bigger. That's going to shift around too, because the shoulder's going to have some mass that's going to peek over. This is going to have some mass. So things will get shifted a bit once it's in the foam as well. I'm going to put some tape on this, clean it up real quick. Part of what might be hard to explain is that what the pattern's going to be can be changing throughout the entire process from the very start until we get to the end of the muscle suit. So whatever I draw on the paper right now, it doesn't necessarily have to be what the end result of the muscles are, but it's just giving me like rough guidelines of where I want to put things, and then I can cut out the big foam muscles and shape them and tweak them from there. Some of it also, as I'm going, is like, as I'm drawing the shapes, it's like, oh, this shape would be cool here. And it's not necessarily like this is 100% anatomically correct, but none of it is, because we're not doing 50 different muscles overlapping each other. But if you decide like, okay, this mass here is going to look cool and also convey the roughly the correct anatomy, and I think that's okay to go with as well. Also, if you're doing a creature or something, you have more leeway there, because what's this creature's muscle structure going to look like? We don't know. It could be like a human. It could not. Now that I've redrawn this, you can see this muscle didn't actually get that much bigger. I just needed to shift it where it was once all the lines were drawn around. So, all right, then coming down to the butt, you probably want to give yourself some cakes.
Most superheroes got a butt. You want a butt.
So the crack of the cheeks, as it were, is going to be right where your center line is.
And then
just bring that down to where your butt is on the mannequin. If you want like more overhang, you can do that. If you want to do like a giant block of foam and carve out the underhang of the bum, that's an option. We're just going to do a relatively muscular, proportional butt to the rest of this. So this round's over here. And then there are a couple options depending on the type of definition you want. You can have this come like this and taper into the thigh stuff, or you can give it a crescent moon shape on the side of the butt to make it look more pronounced. Because if like your cheeks are flexed, you get this crescent moon shape on the side of the butt. For the back of the thigh here, leading into the back of your knee, sort of like the elbow, it's gonna be like a diamond shape where your knee flexes here. And then there's two muscles coming up this way. And these are kind of just two long, slightly ovaled lumps. If you want for this one, on the front, you can kind of have it curve around to the front of these thigh muscles. That's not exactly how it works, but we can do it to fill this space and give it some mass. And same thing here, you can kind of cup this inward. This one on the inside, you may want to tweak to your preference for your comfort, depending on the gap you have between your thighs already. Because if you do a ton of mass here, then you're going to have these two rubbing together, and that's going to be uncomfortable. So this one you might want to do thin, you might want to do bigger. It kind of just depends on what you're already working with and what you want the look to be. I forgot on the side muscle here, I didn't go over if you wanted to have like the pronounced oblique muscles here. I believe the way these works is it's actually like woven over top of each other. To convey that, usually you can kind of just give like shapes going like this. Rounded shapes diagonally this way before you get to the abs. And then instead of having this come all the way to the side, you would just make this top ab here more pronounced to lead into that.
For the mass on the shoulder and neck here, if you're doing that, you can bring the back muscle up and curve it over, and then have this come up and meet up with this where we curved it up around the neck already. And it depends on how far up you're going. If you're going all the way up to the head, you can taper it up into the head. If you're going just to the collar, you can cut it off at the collar and cut around this over. If you're not having that at all, you know, you can just bring it down as far as you need to bring it down. Same thing with the neck muscle in the front here. It depends how far up you're going. If you want some pronounced neck muscles, you can put those in like that. If you don't want those, you could also put a pronounced collarbone. Neither of those is necessary if you don't want them, but I would just kind of taper them in this way, make them kind of flush leading up to the pec here, and then blow this back out and curve this over. If you're doing a collarbone, it would kind of just be that hard shape coming up, following where your collarbone, that's pretty easy to locate if you just look at yourself and poke where your collarbone is.
I've got all my muscles labeled. It's also a good idea to take a picture of this so you know how things go back together. Now I'm going to cut everything out and stick it onto paper. The masking tape should be relatively easy to peel off of this. You're using a duct tape dummy, at least you can push down on the dummy and pull up on the tape and peel it off that way. Kind of cut this off in sections as you go. And I usually put a hand in between the tape and the fabric to make sure I don't cut the fabric. But this part is kind of slow and tedious. I'm actually going to put a couple hash marks here from this top ab slash rib section and the pec, because I wanted this to come up under the pec when I do it in foam. So a couple lines here. That way I have some extra reference on where to put it back together. So then once you have a section cut off, I just put that down on this big roll of brown paper, just like I did on my foam patterning video.
Alright, my tape has been transferred to the paper. Some of the pieces aren't going to lay down completely flat, like the pec and the shoulder. For the shoulder, I just cut a line in here. That way it can lay a little bit more flat. It's not super important that all these pieces lay completely flat, because I'm going to end up cutting the foam slightly bigger than the pattern anyway, so I can shape it. So we just want it to lay flat enough, and then I can cut all this out. Alright, all my patterns are cut out. In the next video, I'll show you how I cut, shape, and smooth the upholstery foam. I do already have a video titled How to Carve Upholstery Foam for Muscle Suits that goes over some of this, but in the upcoming video, I'm gonna go a little bit more in-depth and show how I smooth it and maybe go over some other techniques on how you can cut out your foam for the final product. If you enjoyed this video, consider liking and subscribing, and thank you for watching.
Alright, go ahead.
What do I gotta yawn?
Go ahead.
I got nerves.
It's fine, you can cut this out.